Hi everyone, welcome back to Swift UI Programming on Swift Playgrounds 4. What we're going to do today is, well, not actually Swift UI. We're going to be doing just Swift, and that's the programming language that Apple uses for creating apps on iOS, macOS, tvOS, watchOS, and iPadOS. What we'll do is we'll just learn about the language, so there's nothing to do with SwiftUI or stacks or images or anything. And we'll be using something called a playground in Swift Playgrounds instead of an app in Swift Playgrounds. So let's get started, right? Here we have our ridiculous app from last time, so you can still see my amazing app icon. This time round, you're going to click on plus playground. Let's tap on that. And it's going to make a new playground for you. And just like before, you should probably rename this. I'm going to ask you to rename this to Swift Lesson, or whatever you really want to call it. I'm perfectly fine with anything. So Swift Lesson, I'm going to press done. And if you tap on it, you're going to see that what you get is a little bit different from what we saw the last time round. Did I actually tap on it? Let me tap on it again. No, I did not tap on it. So as you can see here, it's a little bit simpler than before. There's no longer an app preview on the right. There's still a sidebar button. There's still a close button. And there's still a little plus button. Let's go take a look at what all these things do. To no one's surprise, tapping on the sidebar button will open the sidebar. And you can see that it's slightly different from before. Instead of a new button, you have an edit button. Instead of your code, you have some weird stuff over here like a user module and shared code. You can ignore all this and we'll just be working in my playground for the time being. And later on, we'll tell you how to add more playground pages. So let's close this. And over here, if you press plus, plus will actually let you add code. Right, you can actually type in some code. You can add a picture if you feel like it. And over here, you can add a file. We're actually not going to use any of this. The overflow menu, once again, will bring up all these different ways of getting help and things like that. And you can up your font size. And you know what? Let's just start typing some code. There are some new buttons down here. We'll deal with them in a moment. But the most important one is run my code. So let's get started. Tap to enter code. So tap right there and start typing. We're going to go start by saying var string equals to hello world. And here you go. Here's your first line of Swift code outside of SwiftUI. And what you can do is you can tap run my code for it to do pretty much nothing, which is fine, I guess. What we want to do instead is you want to tap on this ABC button over here, and it's going to show you what is happening inside this line of code. Okay, so let's type out a few more lines of code. Var number of cookies equals to 10. Var my name equals to cookie monster. Var am I hungry equals to true. Hey, good stuff. So what are we doing over here? What's var, right? Var. So var is called a declaration. You are essentially telling Swift, hey, make me a little box that stores the number 10 and call it number of cookies. Make me a box that stores the words cookie monster and call it my name. Make me a box that stores true, that's for some reason a nice shade of purple, and call it am I hungry. Okay? And once you've made these boxes, you've declared these variables, now you can actually use them. So number of cookies, again, autocomplete as before, press enter. Number of cookies can be equals to, let's say, 0. We ate all the cookies, we are Cookie Monster. Okay. And if you run your code again, you're going to see that the code runs in sequence from top to bottom, and it's going to update the number of cookies from initially 10 up here. If I tap here, it was 10. And now it's 0. Okay, very sad, but at least you ate a whole bunch of cookies. And that's simple enough, right? This is just declaring variables. This is data, right? This is just how Swift stores data. And you're going to need to store data and access data and make changes to data. And that's what we're going to be learning about for most of this lesson. So what else can we do with all this? Well, we can declare variables a different way by using the word let. And I'm going to say let number of donuts equals to 5. And what this means is we are creating a constant. All right, what's a constant? Let's show by changing number of donuts equals to zero. And what that does is it actually gives me an error. Here's an error over here. Let's tap on the red icon over here to see what the error is. It says, oh, change let to var to make it mutable. That's a pretty useful error message, actually, because mutable means something that can be changed. And we use the word let. And what this word does is it says number of donuts is a constant. It cannot be changed. So over here, this line and this line both give us an error because I said make it unchangeable and then I stupidly tried to change it. Right. So don't do that kind of thing. If you declare it as a constant, that means you don't want to change it. You might be wondering, why do you need to actually declare constants if you're not going to change it? Well, you could have things that are going to remain the same throughout your code. So maybe your app only supports 5 players or something. You can declare it as let number of players equals to 5. Use it in your code later on, but you might have a chance to expand your app and say, oh, number of players is now 6. But you're never going to change it during the running of the app itself. I hope that kind of makes sense, but not to worry. We'll probably see this again. Okay, so how are we going to fix this error? Well, we could delete this line of code, or we could do this. We could go to the beginning of number of donuts and type /:// What that does is it comments out this line of code. That means this line of code is going to be completely ignored by Swift, and it's just there for us humans to look at. The robots cannot see it. This is something useful to know when the robots inevitably rise up and try to murder all of us. Comments, very useful. So you can also use comments to just type messages to yourself, because who doesn't like talking to themselves while coding? So // over here, this is a constant. I'm not exactly sure why Swift Playgrounds decided to add some space before this constant, but we'll just let Swift Playgrounds be and, you know, leave it alone, right? So over here, these are actually variables. I'm going to press enter and //. These are variables. Swift Playgrounds, you see? Why you do this? All right. Give me space before the other one, but not this. Who knows why? I do not know why. Okay. But what's important is that these //s say that they are comments and these are just messages to tell ourselves what's going on. So as you are doing all this, you might type in all these little comments to tell yourself about more of what's going on, so that you can come back to this tomorrow and read through your code and understand it better.